The eyes of the Lord preserve knowledge, but he overthrows the words of the faithless. My name's Arthur, and I thank you for joining me as we share some thoughts prompted by this verse, coming from Proverbs chapter 22, verse 12. The eyes of the Lord preserve knowledge, but he overthrows the words of the faithless. For us, knowledge is expressed in words, which is really a fantastic ability that we have, to have a symbolic representation by which we can transfer ideas from one to another, just by speaking. It's the fact that knowledge is contained in words that makes evolution absolutely foolish. For our DNA is a library of words, instructions for building our body. Because words have meanings independent of the actual expression of the word, whether written, in braille, spoken, semaphore, or Morse code, which are independent of the actual meaning and in that way convey knowledge. John identifies Jesus as the Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. There was this knowledge of and wisdom and understanding, which was encapsulated in a symbolic form, as it were, in the Word, before the material world existed, became reality as he built it. It's like you can write a blueprint on a piece of paper. You can express it in words and symbols, and then you can put it into practice. But the plan is not the reality. God brings to pass everything that is in his plan. The eyes of the Lord preserve knowledge, but he overthrows the words of the faithless. Just as God speaks, and so it is, so also men speak. But men's words do not have the power of God's words. Men say things, they make promises, they give accounts of things that have happened, but these words may not be true. And so God is the one who judges the words. And we're told that all of our words will be revealed, exposed, and we will be judged according to our words. The things that come out of our mouths will be assessed to reveal what is in our hearts, and we will be found guilty because of them. He overthrows the words of the faithless. When Sennacherib was overrunning the world with his mighty army around 725 BC, he'd overrun the northern kingdom of Israel, and he sent a delegation up to Jerusalem saying, "Open the gates and submit to me. It's useless you fighting against me. You don't have the army to resist me. You don't have the resources. You'll just bring great pain and suffering on yourself if you resist me. And don't think your God will help. Which of the gods of any of the nations have succeeded in defeating me? In fact, your God told me to come and take you over." But Hezekiah refused to open the gates. Instead, he went to his God. And when Sennacherib put these things down in words written on a piece of paper, he took the piece of paper and laid it before God and said, "God, do you see what this man is saying? He is saying that you are just like the gods of all the other nations. Those gods, who are no gods, have not saved their people. But you are the living God. And so we ask that you save us and show Sennacherib who is the living God." And that's what the Lord did. Sennacherib didn't fire an arrow in Jerusalem, for the Lord slew his army. 185,000 men dead in one night. And when Sennacherib went home, he bowed down to his false god. even though he knew that it was the God of heaven who had defeated him. He still aligned himself with his false God. And while he prayed to his false God, two of his sons assassinated him. God is the one who overthrows the words of the faithless. Sennacherib refused to acknowledge God, and so he was overthrown. Pharaoh was exactly the same in the time of Moses. Pharaoh refused to acknowledge God. At the beginning, he claimed ignorance. Who is this God of the Hebrews? Although it's only 200 years since Joseph was the grand governor of the nation, he knew of the God of Israel. But anyway, he claimed ignorance. But after the Lord had demonstrated his power, he could no longer use that excuse, but still he refused to obey the living God. And so he brought great suffering on his people, and ultimately his son was killed and his army defeated in the Red Sea. The Lord overthrows the words of the faithless. This contrasts with what the Lord does for the words of the faithful. We're told concerning Samuel that he grew and the Lord was with him and let none of his words fall to the ground. The eyes of the Lord preserve knowledge. Knowledge comes with truth, with understanding, and with wisdom. And there is no knowledge against God. He preserves it. The eyes of the Lord, he sees and understands everything. The eyes of the Lord preserve knowledge. We're told in Colossians, I want you to know what a great conflict I have for you and those in Laodicea, and for as many who have not seen my face in the flesh, that their hearts may be encouraged, being knit together in love, attaining to all the riches of the full assurance of understanding, to the knowledge of the mystery of God, both of the Father and of Christ, in whom are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. All the treasures of understanding, wisdom, and knowledge are hidden in God. They are not automatically known by us, so they are the secret things of God, the knowledge of the mystery of God. But these things are revealed to those who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, that we might attain the full assurance of understanding to the knowledge of the mystery of God, both of the Father and of the Son. God holds this knowledge, but he has revealed it to men through his prophets, and that revelation is contained for us in the Scriptures. And the Scriptures have been preserved in a most incredible way over many centuries. Our New Testament is almost 2,000 years old, and the Old Testament much older. But it's the foundation of the knowledge of God. And the words of God, we're told in the Psalms, were actually from eternity. And the Scriptures form the foundation of the knowledge of God. And this knowledge is preserved for us, despite many attempts in history and at the present time to destroy it and contradict it. So when we say the eyes of the Lord preserve knowledge, the Lord sees everything that is happening in this world, and he filters the things that are happening in this world to filter out the words of the faithless and the bad words, but to preserve the words that are true. The Lord sees, and therefore the Lord acts. He works to preserve, because it is through the knowledge of him that we find salvation. These are the words of life, preserved for us, so that we might live.